My name's Logan May. I'm a defenseman for the London Knights, and I'm from Belgrade, Ontario.
That one taken away by Mayu. Good job there. Silky mitts by the defenseman. Now, Vinogradov. Back to Mayu. Mayu comes in, rifles a shot, he scores! Logan Mayu!
Probably, I'd say, as a bigger guy, I think my skating's pretty well. I think I use it to my advantage, whether it's closing on guys defensively or sort of rushing the puck or sort of using my reach to get away from guys. So I definitely think I like to use my skating as a bigger guy, for sure. Yeah, I'd say I'm a two-way defenseman. Good skating with sort of an offensive knack for the game. I enjoy the physical side of the game as well, and I think I'm a good puck-moving D-man.
Mayu, väldigt fint samspel med Paluka. Mayu, vilket skott han får till!
Yeah, I mean, it's been a crazy, obviously, year and a half here, or a couple of years, but I just think it's just been big with them sort of staying in touch all the time. We're always talking, whether it's training, doing sort of team Zoom workouts, or they're just checking in to see what's going on with on-ice training and stuff like that, or whether they're breaking down NHL video, sort of game clips and everything. So, I mean, they're doing as much as they can. I think they go overboard all the time, which I think definitely helps the players. That's big for us, especially with what happened this year with us not being able to play, sadly. So I think they've done a great job at sort of staying in touch and keeping guys on the right track. Yeah, it was cool. I mean, it was pretty much like my first time being in Europe. But I mean, I was 17 years old, living across the world pretty much alone. So I ended up living with a guy on the Windsor Spitfires, Matt Maggio, as well. So we were living together. But it was just a cool experience. I mean, it was fun just to sort of get to know the culture over there, to see the differences in everything, whether it's culture, hockey, everything like that. So it was definitely a cool experience. And I mean, it was just fun to play some games too. So you're playing pro hockey, you got to play against men. Just being around guys who are 20, like the young guys on the team are 23 years old, 22 years old. So it's like we're 17-year-old kids, and we sort of got to try and make an impact in the game. And you got to try and be a difference maker every night. So it's definitely something where you see how different it is in pro, and how it's not just at the rink. Guys are dialing in on their game. It's at home, it's in the gym, it's everywhere. So
now tries to throw that one to Keitley. Keitley was moving on the other side. Now Logan Mayhew's got all kinds of time. Takes the shot. Keitley on the doorstep. And the Nationals are going to make it 7-2.
Yeah, I think one of the main guys probably last year on the Knights was Luke Evangelista. He ended up going to Nashville in the second round. And he sort of had a funny year because, I mean, 16-year-old year, didn't play too much, didn't get too much chances and stuff like that. And then his next year, he took a huge leap and huge steps moving forward in his game. And so he just sort of, he drove me to school every day in the morning too. So we talked every day pretty much about everything going on. So it was pretty cool to just see him stay humble as much as he can. Like, he ended up going pretty high in the second round. He's probably one of the most humble people I've ever met. And he's just a great guy. So it was awesome to just see him go through that and see him sort of climb the rankings and everything like that in the process. And now he's signed to an NHL contract. So he's definitely been a main guy who I sort of watched and got to see him go through it and sort of try and take some stuff. And just so good in London with that, with developing players and their development program there. So it's making sure I'm getting all my training and I'm getting my weightlifting and I'm getting stronger, faster, everything like that. But it's not even just in the gym, it's on the ice, it's in practice, skill work in practice, making sure it's the little details and stuff like that. So that's definitely something where we do video every single day in London. So that's something where we sort of break apart everybody's game, and I like that. It's all criticism, it's good criticism. So the more that they sort of pick apart my game, the better I can be. So it's definitely just been something where all throughout the board there and throughout the staff in London, I think they've all had a hand in my development for sure.
Malou spelar ju fint över på andra sidan till Laine Fält. Malou sugen på att skjuta. Skjuter också. Gör det mål. Vilket mål han gör. Logan Malou.
It's really stressful right now, obviously. really like anxious and stuff, so I think it'll be fun. I mean, it's busy with interviews and everything right now, and still keeping up with my training, so it's definitely a busy time. So I think I'm just trying to stay focused on myself and my training, making sure I can stay dialed in with that, and then all the pieces will fall where they should. So it's sort of, I've always wanted to be a hockey player. I started playing hockey when I was two, so it's always been a thing for me. But I mean, when you're a kid, you're just playing hockey because you love it. It's just fun. So I mean, it sort of sets in probably around 11, 12 years old, I'd say, something like that. 10 years old, even younger, that I want to be an NHL player. So it's sort of where it starts to get more serious and then in the later stages, but it's always been a dream.